So how's it going, guys and girls? It's Oak here, back with another video for you guys. Today what I've got for you is going to be another video with my friend Toby to my left. You guys should all know who Toby is by now. We've done loads of videos together. This is actually going to be a video similar to when we did, I think we were sat here again actually.
The exact spot.
We were switched around a little bit, and also we took into consideration the fact that the phone screen is going to be going somewhere around here this time, which is good, which is very, very good. We're back again with FanDuel. However, today, instead of like giving you like an informative video about the app, which you should have already seen if you haven't, there will be a link to the description down below. Today what I'll be showing you is how to actually kind of, not, I don't want to say guaranteed way to make money, but the best method that I've found, or a better way for you guys to actually start earning some money whilst using FanDuel. And by the way guys, this is for 18 year olds and over. It's a gambling app, it's a gambling site if you like. It's kind of like a fantasy league thing, but on a weekly basis. So you pick a team, you enter with X amount of money, say you do like a £5 head to head. Me versus Toby, whoever wins will take that prize fund away with them. So you've got to be gambling aware, make sure that good stuff goes through, and don't do this unless you're above the age of 18, like I've said.
Before we progress any further into the video, guys, I wanted to quickly let you know that when you download FanDuel, make sure you use my promo code, which is Oakley, that's capital O-A-K-L-E-Y. And I also wanted to let you know about this awesome new feature that they've brought in. It's called Late Swap. So basically, even though the majority of my players will be playing at 3 p.m. on a Saturday, I can still change anyone that plays after that. So if Dimitri Payet doesn't start on Sunday, or the Watford boys don't start on Monday, I can still change them after seeing the starting 11, which is obviously an incredible feature to add in. If there's like one player that didn't make the starting 11, you're devastated because you're losing out a lot of points there. It's a good way to rectify that instance. So hopefully you guys like that change and get downloading FanDuel. But for now, let's carry on with the rest of the video.
So today, guys, what we're going to be taking part in is the £6,000 fan favourite. Now, the top prize for this is going to be £600. And Toby, how many people will be making their money back and more?
336.
I thought you were about to say
almost got it wrong.
So as you can see, guys, on my screen right now, there's 1,220 places left available of the 1,411 entries you can go in with. So if you do come in that top,
so everyone that's in there so far, as it stands, is currently doubling their money.
At least £10. Like I said, £600 to the top. I can actually show you it right here. We just go through, hit on it, and then we go to the information right up here. Here's the prize. You can see the big prize structure there. As you can see, if you come first, 600 quid from chucking a fiver in is not bad.
This is where I want to come in. Sorry to interrupt. When we did this last time, the guy that came second and third was the same person.
Yeah, that's what some people do.
He literally killed it.
If they're confident with the team, you can re-enter that same team again. You can do it as many times
so
as you like.
So like 1.5 grand.
Yeah, he made an awful lot of money. But this is exactly it. This is what I want to show to you. It's actually good you brought that up, because that guy kind of knew the method. Now this is, like I said, it's similar to Fantasy League in the sense that you're picking 11 players and stuff. You get 100 million, much like regular Fantasy League. However, you don't get penalized in the same way that you do on Fantasy League. For example, I've got David De Gea in my Fantasy League. He lets a goal in, I'm not getting 6 points, which is what I'd be hoping for, and then you get like the bonus, the match bonus and stuff. With this, you only lose 1 point if they let a goal in, but you'll gain stuff, let me show you, from them making saves. And if they do get clean sheet, they'll get like bonus of 10 points. I think it sounded like I said the S word there, but clean sheet is what I was trying to say. As you can see here.
Shot on target there is 5 points.
Yep.
Tottenham yesterday versus, they had like 30 attempts on goal.
That's exactly what you need to be seeing. Because like I said here, the only stuff you really lose points for are red cards, own goal, missed penalty, and a yellow card. The rest of it, you're just generating points. So like you see here, I'm going through quite slowly, but this is where a lot of people who will be using the app don't actually take it into consideration. Like, I think last time when we did it, I think you put Joe Hart in goal.
Yeah.
You don't want a keeper that's probably, well, you do want a keeper that's obviously gonna try to keep a clean sheet.
You want one to be
You need someone that's like constantly deflecting shots. And if you can also have the person that's firing those shots at him, that's even better. You don't want someone that's probably not going to have too much to do. You want to have something like Borac for Bournemouth. He got like a lot of points in one of them. Gomez for Watford. He's like charging away. You want people like that that are actually active.
Even if you concede like 3 goals, but you make,
you only lose 3 points.
Saves.
Yeah, that's
still
good.
Huge.
That's massive the points.
Okay, now I know the points. I think I can.
Oh mate, it's so good to make some decent. And the thing is, they come from teams that you wouldn't expect.
Yeah.
So anyway, let's get that. So we've seen all the prizes, you've seen how the point structure works now, and hopefully we're gonna be able to show you the best way to maximize your chances of actually winning some serious money here. I've had a few annoying instances where like one game's cost me severely, but I've still managed to do all right. So this is it, guys. So you're gonna start off with our goalkeeper here, as you can see. Now it automatically goes to price high and low, but what we were going with earlier is if you go and look at these average points, so they got David De Gea, Schmeichel, I can't pronounce this chap's name,
Jakubovic.
Yeah, you got it, you nailed it for me. Let's have a look at the average points here though. And there you go, look. Someone that, whole keeper, you wouldn't expect him to be as high up a lot, because you know, they're more,
see,
more
I
would like to see goals.
I was just about to say that I would pick, for this team, I would pick Fabianski, who have City.
Yeah,
because now you think there, why would you pick him? Because he's going to concede a lot of goals. But he's actually also going to save a lot of goals.
And yeah, he's putting in more of a shift.
And it's point proven by Fabianski as the second
quite the highest
coverage rate.
So you've got Liverpool season. Though as well versus Hull. That's another big, they're two quite, it's a difficult one to go with. They're both
Arsenal,
cost the
Chelsea,
exact same.
Both goalkeepers are very, very involved.
But the thing is that game could go one of two ways.
Yeah.
It could either be very boring or very high scoring. I'm going Fabianski here. I'm going to go with
all three goalkeepers there, I think, are safe bets.
They are, definitely. So now we've still got on the average points. You've got Davis, who has actually, I've actually had him in quite a few as like one of my defenders. He's been like, he's been very, very solid. And it is a little bit weird putting quite a few Hull players in, but these are the guys that are getting the points. And this is what it's about. Like, you need to kind of throw away the your former rule book, as it were, but this is what you want. You want to go for the guys that have been proven to get points. So that's what we're going to do next. Dan is someone I've had in quite a lot.
Coleman would be a great shout.
Bournemouth as well.
Everton are in incredible form, and he scored at the weekend.
All right, we'll go with Coleman and Dan.
About 6.2 mil.
Yeah,
for the second
I know,
most
dude,
average.
This is the thing, man. People think you need to go really expensive, but this is the midfield, to be fair. You do splash out a bit. I'm going to go with Kapuwe, who's already up there, as you can see. He's been unbelievable. I think he's had, what? How many games have been? Three? Four games?
Yeah.
You've got three or four goals and an assist. He's been absolutely smashing it, so definitely getting him in.
They're doing very, very, very
who
bad.
Do they have? West Ham have...
They've conceded four goals in the last two games.
Let's have a look at who West Ham actually are playing. They're playing Southampton, and they're at home.
So I would back Southampton in that.
This is the thing, it's about how much your shift he's going to put in.
Yeah, he could still bang a goal. Well, he did bang a goal.
I think I'm happy with
it. Yeah, even though they did get banged 8-0 over the last two weekends.
I think Lukaku's definitely... He's got to go in. Yeah. He's on fire at the moment. Definitely got to slide him in. But this is where it gets a little bit. Because normally, I'm just going to end up putting Ibrahimovic in.
He's more injured.
He's inconsistent. He might. Well, it doesn't
surprise
me.
He's got a really nice guy.
Probably stubbed his toe in the locker room or some sort of nonsense. We're going to have to sell someone here because we're spending too much money. All right, this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to have to remove him. I'm not saving that much money by doing it. But Townsend versus Sunderland, he was a menace on the weekend
as well.
He's
got a banging goal the weekend.
He's a menace, Townsend is.
Banging goal.
I mean, we could go with Payet. But then we're putting quite a lot of... We have taken Antonio out. Okay, let's put Payet in. Now we've got 4.5 on average for the next two players.
Definitely take Ibra out. And go with...
I mean... Firmino, who do we think's gonna pop the goals in? We could go with Iheanacho.
Iheanacho, I'm seeing.
Yeah.
I'd be 8.4 million.
It's not too much, and he popped a goal in there. And if Aguero's not playing, he will be. So this is the team we're currently looking at, guys. Like, I'm thinking. Oh, I'm not. It's so difficult to say, but. I think it's actually a pretty solid bet. Like, we've got some solid all-rounds in there. Guys that are in form. Obviously, we had to get rid of Kevin De Bruyne because he's just too much money. I would have liked to have Ibra in
16
there.
16 mil is.
But 15 million, like, when you need players that can provenly get you the points that you need. But at the same time, you can't just be sacrificed. Like, if we put Ibra in and De Bruyne, that's already 30 million, not over 30 million, almost 32 million gone. But whereas now, I'm happy with it. I actually think this could be like a pretty, I think it's a pretty safe bet, mate.
So we, instead of Poyet and Ibra, we're Gundogan and Iheanacho.
Yes.
Against Swansea. I think they're gonna have.
And it's against Fabianski. So like we said, if these guys are popping off the shots and he's saving them, shot on target, 5 points. If they do get a goal, fine, we lose the points from Fabianski, but we gain God knows how many. How many points do you get for a freaking goal? That loads and loads.
15, was it?
15 points per goal. Boom. 15 points per goal. It's gonna be. I think this is the winning formula. So that's it, guys. That's my like winning formula, if you like, on how to make money and how to win on Fanduel. Like I said, this is an 18+ app. If you haven't already got it, check out the link in the description down below. And don't forget to gamble aware. We're gonna find out after this weekend how well my team's actually gone on, or got on rather. This will be going up on Thursday evening. So you're gonna be able to see just how well I've got on. Like I said, my name's Oakelfish. Oh, I didn't actually say it, but my name's Oakelfish on FanDuel. If you wanna see how I'm getting on during the actual tournament, then be sure to go check it out. Hopefully you'll see me up the top winning 600 quid with this. Obviously it's Thursday now, entered it, and you wanna...
You're not allowed to copy our...
Don't copy our team. Our team, but head over. If there's any players you might win, make sure you why not. Any watching, guys, like I said, don't forget the description down below. 18+ only. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day. I'll catch you in a bit. See ya.